Julia. Julia! Julia! Julia!
What? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Have you guys ever been on a train playing on your phone and suddenly you've missed your train stop? Or if you're like me and your family thinks you've suddenly gone deaf when you've got your nose stuck in a book? This has become an actual recurring problem in my life, but aha, science vindicates me. Apparently, focusing on something visual makes us kind of deaf, and it happens to most of us. It's called inattentional deafness, according to a study published in the journal Attention, Perception, and Psychophysics. The researchers tested over 100 participants and had them focus on tasks on a computer screen, and they played a noticeable tone. When the task demanded more attention, 8 out of 10 participants failed to notice the tone. And this isn't exactly news. Humans aren't that good at paying attention to lots of different things at the same time. We can focus, we just can't pay attention to what's going on around us. Researchers have known for years about inattentional blindness, which, like it sounds, is when you don't see something happening because you were focused on something else. The classic example is the invisible gorilla test, where you watch people pass a basketball back and forth and count how many times they passed it. But in the middle of the video, a person in a gorilla suit walks in, beats their chest, and walks out. In one study of this video, 42% of people didn't notice the gorilla at all because they were so focused on the basketball. So what's going on? Well, a recent study published in the Journal of Neuroscience found our brains aren't as efficient as we'd like to think. In this small study, researchers hooked up 13 volunteers to a brain activity measuring device called an MEG. This machine is used to measure how long it takes for an unusual sensory signal to get from your brain to your consciousness. Basically, how long it takes for you to recognize something after you see or hear it. This typically takes 300 milliseconds and is referred to as a P3 reading. In the study, the volunteers were given a visually demanding task, like matching things on a computer. While they were engrossed in their task, the researchers again played a tone. The scientists found that the volunteers were so focused on matching things, their P3 response was suppressed, which means they didn't consciously perceive the sound. And another reading suggested that they didn't even hear it. The MEG also looked at activity in the superior temporal sulcus and the posterior middle temporal gyrus, which are parts of the brain that usually light up in response to hearing a sound. But since the volunteers were so focused on the task, even this reading was weak. So really, when you're focusing really hard on something, your brain barely even hears it, and it doesn't even reach your consciousness. The researchers found that this is because the senses of hearing and vision share a limited neural resource. Simply put, your brain doesn't have the resources to consciously perceive multiple things at the same time. So take that, Mom and Dad! I wasn't ignoring you when I was reading. I literally couldn't hear you. I have a hard enough time focusing as it is. Ooh, shiny. Anyways, is the internet making our attention span shorter? I find the answer in this episode right here. The average American receives more than 15 hours a day of digital media. Everything from YouTube videos and Netflix movies to computer games and text messages. By the age of 7, a child born today will have spent the equivalent of one full year watching screens. So tell me your stories of times when you've missed super obvious things because you weren't paying attention. Like that one time I missed that stop sign because I was jamming out to T-Swift in the car. Oops. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single episode of DNews.